Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about micro-teaching. Micro-teaching is a practicum in BEd curriculum. Now, what is micro-teaching? In the word micro-teaching, there are two words, micro and teaching. We know the meaning of both the words individually. But then, what is the meaning of the word micro-teaching? Micro-teaching is a scaled-down version or a smaller version of teaching. It is the practice of teaching. In BEd, we learn how to teach the students. We learn how to embrace the skills of teaching. The classroom cannot be used as a platform for acquiring primary teaching skills. We need to learn the techniques or the procedure of teaching before we start teaching the students. We cannot practice teaching in the classroom. We need to learn it beforehand. And that is why the concept of micro-teaching has come. In micro-teaching, the student teacher or the teacher trainee delivers a small portion of her unit to a small group of students or sometimes to her peers for say 5 to 10 students within a small time period of 10 to 12, 20 minutes. And the whole encounter is video recorded. After that, the student or the peers give the student trainee or the teacher trainee a constructive feedback, which the teacher reviews, evaluates it, amends her approach, and then again reteaches the same lesson to another group of students and then reviews and re-evaluates it again. Contents: meaning and concept of micro-teaching, definition of micro-teaching, objectives of micro-teaching, nature and characteristics, phases of micro-teaching, steps of micro-teaching, principles underlying micro-teaching, utility of micro-teaching, merit of micro-teaching, demerit of micro-teaching, Indian model of micro-teaching, format of micro-teaching through stimulation, format of feedback, skill of introducing the lesson, skill of questioning, skill of using teaching aids, skill of reinforcement, skill of illustration with examples, conclusion, and lastly reference. Micro-teaching. Micro-teaching is a teaching technique which requires student teacher to teach a unit using specified teaching skill to a number of pupils in a short duration of time. After the class, the teacher trainee receives a constructive feedback from the students or from her peers about what has worked and what improvements can be made in her teaching technique. Many educationalists and psychologists have given the definition of micro-teaching. Two of them are shown here. Simulation. The word simulation means a situation in which a particular set of conditions is created artificially in order to study or experience something that could exist in reality. Simply, we can say simulation is the act of pretending that something is real when it is not. Presently, the application of simulation is also being used in the sphere of teaching education. The main objective of micro-teaching is to modify the teacher's behavior according to some specified objectives. Thus, the objective of micro-teaching is to make the classroom communication more effective and more interactive. Nature and characteristics of micro-teaching. Phases of micro-teaching. There are three phases of micro-teaching. The first phase is the pre-active phase or knowledge acquisition phase. In this phase, the teacher trainee acquires the knowledge of teaching skills and prepares a lesson plan of how to use the skills during the teaching. The second phase is the interactive phase or skill acquisition phase. The teacher trainee performs her skills in a simulation mode and receives a feedback on her teaching skills. The third phase is the past active phase or transfer phase. This is the phase where the teacher trainee teaches in a real classroom while integrating all the teaching skills. Micro-teaching cycle. There are six steps in micro-teaching. The first step is planning.
In this step, the teacher trainee prepares a lesson plan or learning design and plans a logical sequence of classroom activities. The second step is teaching. This step involves the attempts of the teacher trainee to use the components of learning skills in suitable situations in the process of teaching learning in the classroom. The third step is feedback. The teacher trainee's peers or also an expert gives a constructive feedback on her performance, which helps her to improve in the desired direction. The fourth step is replanning. The teacher trainee, on the basis of the feedback, replans her lesson with the required modifications. The fourth step is reteaching. The teacher trainee reteaches the modified lesson to another group of students. The sixth step is re-feedback. Again, the teacher trainee receives a feedback from the students on her performance, and thus the cycle continues. Principles underlying microteaching. There are 8 principles. Principle of one skill at a time. In microteaching, the trainee has to master one skill first and then move on to the next. Principle of limited contents. In microteaching, a small portion of a unit is taught in one class. Principle of practice. Microteaching is the practice of teaching so that the teacher can conduct a class more efficiently. Principle of immediate feedback. The feedback of the teaching is given right after the class is over, so the trainee can improve them without any delay. Principle of experimentation. Microteaching is an experiment that consists of observation of actions performed under controlled conditions. The student teacher and the supervisor conduct experiment on teaching. Principle of evaluation. There is continuous assessment of performance of the teacher trainee. Evaluation helps the learner know his or her drawbacks and eventually modify them. Principle of individualized training. Each trainee is given thorough training and attention by the supervisor, who points out the drawbacks and gives suggestion how to improve it. Principle of continuity. Microteaching is a cycle. It is a continuous process of teaching and reteaching. The utility of microteaching is that it helps the teacher trainee practice the art of teaching within a small period of time in front of a small group of students. Thus, due to less number of students, the trainee can pay attention to individual students. Merits of microteaching. Microteaching is a platform for beginner teachers to improve their teaching techniques. It is useful for both pre-service and in-service teachers. It helps to modify teachers' behaviors. It improves the management skills of the teacher. This process boosts confidence for better classroom management. Also, it is budget-friendly compared to seminars or conferences. Also, as there are few students, so the teacher trainee can solve individual problems of the student. Instant feedbacks give potential to the teachers for rectifying their mistakes. Also, the teachers develop a positive attitude towards criticism from the feedbacks. Demerits of microteaching. For microteaching, teachers are given 6 minutes only, which is not always enough for thorough or in-depth teaching. Again, due to limited time period, creativity is hampered. Microteaching is not our regular teaching. It is different. It involves the use of core teaching techniques like introducing, questioning, illustrations, etc. So the trainee teacher needs expert supervision or experienced educators, which is not always possible. Another thing is that microteaching is for the teachers and not for the students. So the students' time gets wasted. Also, in microteaching, the trainee should practice one skill in one class. But teaching is an amalgamation of all the skills. Thus, the use of one skill, one at a time, is a questionable approach. Indian model of microteaching. The concept of microteaching came to India in 1975 When the Department of Teacher Education in NCERT with the collaboration with CASE designed a project to study the effectiveness of micro-teaching. D.D. Tiwari of Government Central Pedagogical Institute of Allahabad was the first to take up this work. The first book on micro-teaching was Modification of Teacher Behavior Through Micro-Teaching, which was written by Dosaj. Dr. Passy, Dr. Singh and Dr. Jagira developed instructional materials which were used to teach or train the teacher educators. The duration of micro-teaching in India is 36 minutes. The time period for each action is divided into 5 steps. For teaching, 6 minutes. For feedback, 6 minutes. For replanning, 12 minutes. For reteaching, 6 minutes. And for re-feedback, 6 minutes. Most of the researchers have suggested that micro-teaching is a good technique. In the first box, you need to give the details of your class. In class, if you are teaching a topic of class 10, then you need to write class 10. In the date, you need to give the date on which you are going to take the class. In the trainee or name, you need to write your own name. And in peer group, you need to write the number of your peers, the number of the students you are going to teach the topic. In subject, you need to give the name of your subject, like English, Maths, History, Geography, Science, etc. In lesson plan, you need to write the name of the unit or name of the chapter you are going to teach. And in today's lesson, you need to write the subunit or the particular topic you are going to teach that day. And in time, you need to write 6 minutes. As you know that the teaching time in micro-teaching is 6 minutes. Format of feedback or evaluation is a table. The column side represents 7-point scale, which include remarks like excellent, very good, good, average, below average, poor, and very poor. And on the row side consists of components which are different for different skills. Tips. From the beginning, I have told you that micro-teaching involves the use of appropriate teaching skills during teaching. So, what is teaching skills? Teaching skills are set of teaching behaviors or teaching acts, like introducing the lesson, explaining the topic, drawing on the blackboard, using teaching aids like charts, models, questioning the student for an interactive classroom communication, etc. These teaching skills aim at specific objectives and are performed with an intention to facilitate the student's learning. Many educators have given various instructional skills, but the majority which are practiced in most teacher training institutions are skill of introducing the lesson, skill of explaining, skill of stimulus variation, skill of questioning, skill of reinforcement, skill of illustration with examples, skill of using teaching aids, and skill of achieving closure. Skill of introducing the lesson. This is also called skill of motivation. We start our class with this skill. This is the most important skill, as the effectiveness of the class depends on how efficiently it has been introduced. Introduction includes greeting the students. For say, good morning students, how are you today, with a smiling face to create a sense of positivity. Then you need to arouse their curiosity by asking something outside the topic, and in the process revive their previous knowledge, and in this way you start your lesson of the day by saying, today we are going to study, and write on the blackboard the name of the lesson. Skill of probing questions. After you have taught the chapter, you need to know how much they have understood the lesson. for which questioning is used. This is a very important skill as it creates an interactive classroom communication. When you probe the questions, it should be precise and there should be clarity of language and no grammatical mistakes, so that it does not create any confusion, or else the students will be scared to answer. The questions you ask should have specific objectives. If a student is not able to answer the questions, then you should give them some hints or prompt some clues, like the word starts with D or the word has 8 letters, etc. Then he will be able to answer the questions. If the student is not able to answer, then you should redirect the question to another student. You should also use the student's responses for further questioning. Like you may ask one student, when is Teachers' Day celebrated in India? And the student will reply on 5th September. Then you ask another student, why is Teachers' Day celebrated on 5th September? And that student will reply that Teachers' Day is celebrated on 5th September because it is the birthday of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who was a professor by profession and the second president of India. And this is how you can create an interactive classroom. Skill of using teaching aids. Teaching aids are added devices in classroom teaching which make teaching learning process more effective and more interesting. There are three types of teaching aids. First, visual aids, which are predominantly used, like the blackboard. Another is audio teaching aid, like audio cassettes, music tape, etc. And lastly, audio visual aids, which are gaining popularity and are generally shown through projectors with the help of PowerPoint presentations. When using these teaching aids in the classroom, this should be displayed properly so that it is clearly visible from all the corners of the room. Now, while using a teaching aid, it should always be relevant to the topic. For example, if you are taking an algebra class, then you can make a chart showcasing the algebraic formulas so that the students can refer to the chart while doing the sums. Again, the teaching aid should be appropriate to the student's level. For example, if we take the example of algebra chart, then you should only write the formulas which are in their standard or in their syllabus. The teaching aids shows the creativity of the teacher. And it is also proven that the students learn better when there is a teaching aid, when they visualize something. Skill of reinforcement. Reinforcement are rewards or praises that the students receive after their response. When a student gives a correct answer, you say very good, excellent, very well explained to praise them for their response. So these are positive verbal reinforcements. Again, sometimes you can nod the head or smile or pat the child, which are forms of non-verbal reinforcement. If you have an orphan child or a special child in your class, you can give them a compassionate look and always encourage them for a better performance. If a student gives a wrong response, you never use the phrases like you are not good, you are not fit for anything, you are zero, because you are character assassinating them, which is very demoralizing. So if you want to give negative reinforcement, you can say, I am not satisfied with your answer, you can do better, I expect more from you. And in this way, you try to give a positive impact on the student by encouraging them. Skill of illustration with examples. Illustration means to throw light upon a concept or a theme. Illustration helps enhance the power of observation and cognitive skills of the student. When we illustrate a subject matter, with an example, we should keep in mind that the example is relevant to the topic. For example, in the COVID-19 pandemic, we can ask the student about PPE and then explain the usefulness of using the PPE in the hospitals. The examples you give should be easy and simple, and it should be appropriate to their level. You need to create an interactive environment between you and your students. Microteaching focuses on practicing the essential teaching skills for modification in teachers' behavior and thereafter leads to improved classroom management. It creates an ability to receive criticism with an open mind and boost confidence in the teacher, which help them to conduct their classes with ease and also with enthusiasm.